Have you seen the one that has the screaming goats that goes with that?
That's
That's always a
almost
fun one.
the only thing I can think of when I hear this song. Like, it ruined it for me.
You're listening to the Voice Messages Podcast. I'm Alyssa.
And I'm Lindsay.
We have a passion for music and the voice, and we love sharing the insights we've gained to help others elevate their voices and their lives.
In this podcast, we will listen to what's really going on in the voices all around us to see what messages there are for us in our own voices. Presented by A Love Voice Studio. For today's voice message, I was in the car, we were driving in the car, and Brad, first of all, my husband, Brad, loves VoicePlay. And on his playlist that we just listen to when he's driving, because when is my turn, I listen to my playlist, but when he's driving, anyway, VoicePlay comes up, and there's a song that is by VoicePlay. You know who VoicePlay is, right?
They're like an acapella group.
Acapella
right?
group. Yeah, they were on the sing off. And yeah, anyway, yeah. they were. So when they were on the sing off, they brought in a girl. There was all these guys, and they brought in a girl, and her name was Honey. They don't always have a girl with them, but they do right here. And so, but the girl that was on voice or sing off is not this girl. This girl's name is Rachel Potter.
I'm curious about who Rachel Potter is. I was going to ask you if you knew, because I don't, I have never heard of her before. And she totally does like country stuff now, but she is known for her performance on Broadway as Wednesday Addams in the Addams Family.
Well, sure she is.
Interesting.
That is interesting. Anyway, we were listening and VoicePlay's Trouble came on, and I've always been intrigued by Trouble because Taylor Swift and like the tone, that's what just what's going on with her voice. So I want to listen to Taylor Swift. Some good T Swift on Trouble, and just listen to what's going on and then compare it to what Rachel Potter does with the exact same passage. Here's Taylor Swift, Trouble.
Okay.
I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now. Flew me to places I've never been. Till you put me down. Oh, I knew you were trouble when you walked in.
Side note, have you seen the one that has the screaming goats that goes with that?
That's almost the only thing I can think of when I hear this song. Like, it ruined it for me.
Okay, so glad we brought that up. Okay, so one of the, like, before we go on to Rachel Potter, just, like, noticing how like, engaged she is on those lower notes, and then those top notes definitely let go of that, like, the thickness of the tone.
Yes.
So you've got, like, a thicker sound on the bottom and then a lighter sound on the top. And then I also noticed this time more than I ever have before, like, how... it was not legato, like really broken up, like it had that separation between them. Do you want to hear that again, or do you want to go to Rachel Potter?
No, I want to hear it one more time.
Okay.
I knew you were trouble when you walked in, so shame on me now. Flew me to places I've never been, till you put me down. Oh, I knew you were trouble when you walked in.
Gotta stop it before the goats. It's so interesting, like what that would feel like to sing just like that.
Just flip almost. You're almost flipping from like a really connected place and then purposely blowing apart.
Well, even almost like a pressed place, like
weight.
Not as much weight. Not as much weight. And that's, I mean, that's stylistically common these days, especially if you go over your bridge. Not in every place in this song. I think I've listened to it specifically for this. Not every, I knew, that's not that high. That top note, I think it's a B flat. And so, I knew you were, right? It's just, it is that flip. It's right on that first bridge. Yes. So when you've got the weight on the bottom one, that press where you're leaning more into it, you're going to have to adjust to be able to keep that same kind of, well, if you're going to keep that same kind of weight, you got to negotiate that a little bit, because that's just, that's right. It's either going to flip or it's going to crack, or you've got to modify your valve. Let's see what Rachel Potter does. Same spot.
Okay. I noticed was that almost a little bit that when she was singing the lower notes, mm-hmm. that it was almost a little bit lighter, but so, so clear.
Yeah, that's what I was noticing too. It's not that the top is so different. It's that the bottom is so different.
It's so much lighter, but clear, piercing clear. So that when she makes that flip or makes that jump, she's able to stay in that mix.
She doesn't sound like she's losing power. She's just not trying to push anything. Where Taylor Swift is intentionally using more weight and to get that contrast. And Rachel Potter is not using that weight. She's not trying to get the contrast. She's also a little more legato in her performance.
Yes. It's a little bit faster too. Like it's faster, quite a bit faster.
Sure. Yeah.
She
yeah.
absolutely has to kind of keep that legato.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Good point. Here it is again. Eyes on me, cause I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now, fool me to places I've never been. Till you put me down, oh, I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now, fool me to places I've never been. Now I'm lying on the cold hard ground.
You probably didn't want to elicit the goats either at that part. So she was like, we got to change this line.
What I really noticed about this is that her character, her natural, like, this is what I sing. She's singing true to her instead of trying to be someone else.
Yes.
Which reminds me of, you know, when we were discussing Jack Black, that Jack Black's got this whole myriad of colors that he chooses from. Rachel Potter probably does too, but she's singing in these colors and it's working for her. It's totally working for her, but she's not trying to do all the things at once. Mm-hmm. She's just doing what she does super well. And I've heard her in multiple things with voice play and with a huge range as well, but it's still staying in like, this is my niche, and and good for her for just like, I know where I shine, so I will shine here.
Yes. Yes. And then to like, I guess Taylor Swift's like, for hers, I think it, like we were saying, it's a very stylistic choice for her to flip like that. And I wonder if it plays more emotional, because I do think that Taylor Swift's music is a lot more of that, like it's meant to make her listeners feel a lot
emotional. Where it's that's interesting, especially because I mean voice play, not that a cappella groups are not trying to evoke emotion,
right
but also like the novelty is like, we just do this with our voices, you know, and it's super cool.
And it sounds great.
But I wonder if that, because they're all the voices and they're focused on, well, these are our instruments, so we have to tune these. We have to be consistent to be with each other, at least for the, you know, the backup vocals, that you lose some of that liberty.
Exactly.
Exactly. I've not thought of that before. Fascinating. Okay, so what's the message? What's the takeaway?
A couple things are coming to my mind. For one, it's like, find what you love to do and you're good at and do it well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that there's nothing wrong with that. You can be successful and do what you do and you're free really doing that. Yeah.
Perfect it. Yeah. And that there is definitely skill involved in that still, you know, like the absolute Absolutely. And then I guess on as well as, you know, that there are like picking maybe outside of the box choices or alternative choices is can lend to the emotionality of a piece sometimes.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's really good. I like that. The takeaway. Yeah. Just, yeah. Exploring those vocal colors. What will you get? What are you sacrificing when you do? Mm-hmm. Maybe that's one of the messages. Like, what do I sacrifice if I go into this breadth of color?
Yes.
Because, and will there be a sacrifice? Because Rachel's not really, well, I guess her sacrifice is the breadth of color.
Right, right.
And does like that, every pitch sounds beautiful. And not that Taylor's doesn't sound, I say like she and I are best friends, you know.
I know.
Me and T.
Swift.
It's not like Taylor Swift's, it doesn't have beauty in it, but mm-hmm. she is leaning more into some aggressive sounds and getting a little bit more, especially with the title of the song Trouble, but to have that contrast. And maybe that is what the emotion is evoking. Like, with that back and forth, that whiplash. Yeah. Messages. I like that.
I like
that. And that's our voice message for the week. Go forth.
Create and elevate.
And use your voices wisely. Bye.
Bye. Bye.